Travel with your own risk.
Yeah.
They never even worth shooting.
Oh, you know what? Oh, yeah, this is the old rattan, and it's just kind of general storage. Oh, is that the those pinwheels and such?
Yeah. We used to hang lambettes from them and had pushers and hang them straight up down, and they'd spin and like almost like an M80 effect. They drop them.
Yeah, what was it called again?
Lambettes, were called.
No kidding.
From them.
So that would, what would make the wheel spin?
We had actual pushers that we put on them.
Like rockets. Drivers, yeah.
And it'd shoot them, then it'd have on a time fuse where the lambettes would hang down below it like a foot or so.
Huh.
Then they'd drop them one at a time, or as they spun, they'd throw them.
Yeah. That's kind
of
cool.
It's pretty neat. Some of the old types.
Yeah, I can see you got them there.
Some of the stuff we have in here now, this is stuff we took to Florida. It's actually in the Christmas scene.
Mm-hmm.
It was all lances and set pieces we did all the way from the nativity scene to different effects that we shot in fireworks.
You just need so much storage for all this stuff.
Yeah.
You know?
And
just,
a lot of it's gone by the wayside now. We don't do too much anymore anywhere.
You know, when I was a kid, like in the 60s, growing up, watching fireworks, they always had set pieces.
Yeah, we did. We used to do
tank battles, you know.
I was big in tank battles. We even had an
American flag.
I had one we made here where it was a guy riding a bicycle. He had to push it across the ground. The wheels turned, the guy's legs moved. They pedaled.
Yeah, I'll be there.
The battleships was probably our most popular, though.
Yeah.
Other than the American flag.
Yeah. It was always funny when something would go wrong.
Yeah.
Which seemed to happen quite a bit.
Yeah,
huh?
Definitely.
That's kind of cool. Yeah, everybody needs an escape route, right?
Yeah.
Okay, we'll head back up to the office. Here we are in Bobby's office. Bobby is the daughter of the original owner of this place. And
president of the company.
Yeah, she's the president. And what's nice when you go to an office of a fireworks manager or the owner, you always see some cool memorabilia kind of stuck on the walls and stuff. So we're going to look at some of that. And could you explain this one to us, Bobby?
Sure. The ones here? In the early 60s, these were the original employees that worked for our Class C and our Class B. My father and my brother.
Yeah.
My sister's in there. Oh yeah, old memories back in there. This picture here, this was my sister Delphine. She was president of the company and she passed away. And this was the bridge show in Wheeling, West Virginia for the advertising. This is a picture of the suspension bridge that we do on the 4th of July.
There you go.
So I demo. And her name is Sesame. We order our Class C fireworks from Golden Peak in China, and she's the one that runs Golden Peak.
Okay, we heard of that brand.
Yeah.
Golden Peak.
Golden Peak.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Then my office, excuse it. So we're busy in here. And
oh, I see.
So it's...
There's some...
Right, this was my grandfather, Dominic Presutti. He's the one that brought our company over here in 1932.
From Italy?
From Italy.
Yeah. Okay.
He brought a few relatives with him. We started our company in Bel Air, Ohio, and down in the city. Mm-hmm. And then we brought it up here in this location on County Road 214 in 1942.
Our president Nixon.
Yeah.
Is there.
It's my father shaking hands with President Nixon at the White House.
Now you know what's 70s. Interesting? A lot of people that run fireworks businesses in the United States always have access to presidents. I've seen these pictures a lot of times. You end up doing fireworks shows for political events or something, and
right.
Nice little perk is you get to meet one of the presidents. And I noticed another president in the very next picture.
Clinton. President Clinton, my sister right there with him. That was in St. Thomas on the golf course.
Yeah.
Her and her friends had met President Clinton. He was golfing, so they all decided to golf together.
Now, I remember your father running this business back in the 70s, and here's some older shots of him. Well, I haven't been here in probably 30 years. This is like so interesting.
Right. This was my father here, my sister and me. Here's my sister, and this is my son Cody when he was real young.
Yeah. Is that your father in the black and white one?
That's my father at the Italian festival
there
in West
go.
Virginia, in Wheeling, West Virginia. He's eating a sausage sandwich. Right.
That's great. Well, yeah. We appreciate you coming in and letting us get a quick look around, and we're anxious to see your property. And
sure.
It doesn't take much. Except a little office to run all these fireworks shows and a phone and a whole bunch of places to run.
Oh, definitely, yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, we know you're busy.
It's busy.
Yeah. Thank you. These are plumbing shelves also. Now, this is good if you need to give somebody an explanation of kind of, you know, how a fireworks works. See, when you make one, you put the two time fuses on it. If you remember from some of my other videos, not that you need two in case one doesn't light, you got the other as a backup. And if you remember that black match sticks through there, that was called cross matching, but you don't really see it on here. And this looks like one of the older, more Italian looking ones here.
It is.
Yeah. I might have shot a few of those through the years, but now they're kind of getting harder and harder. To find, you know, because of the change in the regulations. It's unfortunate. Thank you. Have fun. Be safe. Great tour, great piece of history there along with it. Okay, folks, back on the road. And looking for another firework adventure.